students of the 7th standard. The subject cover is their maths. The name of the chapter is the direct proportion and inverse proportion. So right now we take the topic from the direct proportion and inverse proportion is there. Inverse proportion. First, we find the meaning of the inverse proportion. What is the meaning of the inverse proportion? Inverse proportion means if we have the two quantities and out of this one increase and second quantity decrease at the same time, then we call this type of variation or proportion as an inverse proportion. So simply we make a definition there for the inverse proportion. If in two quantities one increase simultaneously and second decrease simultaneously, then this proportion is called as inverse proportion. Means one quantity will be increased and second will be decreased. In this case, we call this type of proportion or variation as an inverse variation. Let us see by the example. Let me take the example of worker and days. If you have the 100 workers and they complete one work in 20 days, how many workers are there? 100. And they complete the work in how many days? There 20 days. Right now, we decrease the number of workers. 100 workers are there, right now we decrease it. Then we take a worker, how many? 50. Then in simple, we require more days. So how many days we require? 40. See, in this case, number of workers are decreased, number of days are increased. Let us take another example here. Right now we increase the workers. First, in the case we take the 100 workers, right now we take the 200 workers for doing the same work. So right now, how many days we require? If the number of workers are increased, then the work should be a fast and the days are required less. So say, at the time of 100 workers, we require the 20 days. Right now, how many days we require? 10? 10 days. So if we find this in case, number of workers increase, then days are decreased. Number of workers are decreased, then days are increased. Means one quantity increase and second quantity decrease. So in this case, we call this as an inverse proportion. So another example from our practice set. So take the example from the practice set. 15 workers take 8 hours to build a wall. How many hours will 12 workers need to build the same wall? Means same work will be there. That the same works, there are 15 workers complete this work in 8 hours. Right now we decrease the number of workers as 12, then how many hours required to complete the work? So let us by the 12 workers takes x hours. Suppose 12 workers take x hours. So arrangement for this question is there. 12 into x means the time taken by the 12 workers. So 12 into x is equal to 15 into 8, that 15 number of workers and 8 hours they need there. So 15 into 8, 15 8s are 120, then 12 into x, 12x. So 12x is equal to 120. Right now, 12 is there multiply, after going side divide, then 120 upon 12 is equal to x. 12 ones are 12, 12 10s are 120. So x is equal to 10. That's why the 12 workers take 10 hours to complete the same one.